Hi students, this is Pravin Kumar. Today I am going to teach about the flow of electrons and drift speed and average drift velocity and what is the electric shock. Already yesterday class, in previous class, already we have discussed about the definitions for electric current, what is the battery and what is the potential difference, what is the electric potential, such kind of the things are completed. Those are the basic fundamentals for the electric current. Next, today, what is the flow of electrons inside the conductor? Means today you are going to see which type of operations are there inside the conductor. How the one conductor which is able to allow the flow of electrons. Suppose then you have to take one iron rod or anything. Okay? Then that inside the iron rod, how the flow of electrons are there. That such kind of the things are we are going to see. Before going to discuss about that, In the 19th century, Joule and Lorentz, scientists, they proposed that one theory, that is nothing but here what you have to take any conductor, it is nothing but flow of electrons, which is allowing the flow of electrons. Suppose this is nothing but one copper conductor, okay? How the conductor is able to allow the flow of electrons means here inside the conductor, these are positive ions. Positive ions are fixed in their locations. Okay, that phenomena is said to be lattice. That is important question. Okay, inside the conductor, the arrangement of a positive ions in their specified locations, that phenomena is called a lattice. Means inside the conductor, the positive ions are fixed at their places. That's why yesterday class I told you what it is, the flow of electrons. Means the protons, they are not able to move. Only electrons are able to move. Positive ions are fixed in their location. This was proposed by the Joule and Lorentz and the scientist. In this, another one important that is nothing but drift speed. What is the drift speed? Actually, what is the drift? Means here, then you may see this diagram. This diagram consists of one conductor and the next one is battery and this is nothing but what? Switch. Here, suppose, before, this is nothing but an open switch here. The flow of electrons are not possible, then whenever the switch is open. Here, suppose this conductor is there, that may be copper or iron or anything. Here, before connecting to the battery, before connecting to the battery, here, positive ions are fixed in their locations, negative ions are like this. Some of the negative ions, those are nothing but electrons, some of the negative ions are moved towards top, some of the negative ions are moved towards the down, as well as some of the negative ions they are moved forward and some of them are backward, like that there. Means, this is nothing but the before connected to the battery. Means, this can be defined as, this type of velocity of electrons are said to be what? Thermal velocity. Before connected to the battery, the negative ions or the negative electrons, they are having the random motions inside the conductor. That type of velocity of electrons are said to be thermal velocity. How they can get the thermal velocity? Means thermal velocity means this is due to the what? Temperature. Temperature is nothing but then you have to take one iron rod, then you will keep the iron rod in your room. Okay. Inside that, the negative ions are always moves randomly, one position to what another position, that is due to what? Temperature. Means already you know about the room temperature is how much, 37 degrees centigrade are there. That 37 degrees centigrade can be observed by that iron rod inside the electrons, they can move randomly. Some of the electrons are top, some of the electrons are moves down, front and back. That type of velocity of electrons are said to be what? Thermal velocity. Total this is happened when it is before connected to the battery. Next one is after connected to the battery. Means the switch is closed. What happened? Here flow of electrons are there. The flow of electrons are like this. The negative electrons are moves towards the water, positive terminal like this. Means whenever the flow of electrons are there, then these negative ions are deviated, means rotates like this. Rotates like this, positive ions. Means here positive terminal is there, right? Whenever we switch on, whenever the battery is connected, this type of electrons are moves like this, and all the electrons which are present inside the conductor, those can be deviated towards the water, positive terminal. This one, this side. So this is nothing but this deviation, this bending is said to be what? Drift. This is said to be what? Drift. Means here, you before connected to the battery, the electrons which are present in the inside conductor, they are having the thermal velocity. And after connected to the battery, the electrons are which are present inside the conductor, those are getting the what? Drift speed. Means actually final definition for drift speed, that is nothing but the velocity of electron that is said to be what? Drift speed. Okay, speed of electron that is said to be what? Drift speed. Drift speed is always responsible for electric current. Electric current is possible with the drift speed of electron. How much drift speed is there for one electron? Means drift speed of electron is 7 into 10 to the power of minus 5 meter per second. Okay, here 7 into 10 to the power of minus 5 meter per second. This is the drift speed of electron. That can be converted into 0.07 millimeter per second. This is the water drift speed of electron. Okay, you have to remember that is the speed of electron, that is said to be water drift speed. What is the importance of drift speed? Means drift speed is responsible for electric current. Okay, that is nothing but water. Thermal velocity completed, drift speed is completed. Next one is nothing but what? Average drift velocity. What is the average drift velocity? Means average drift velocity is defined as the sum of the all the drift speed of electrons present inside the conductor. Means this is nothing but this can be assumed as this is one electron, this is two electron, this is third electron, this is nothing but what? Fourth electron. Drift speed of this first electron is how much? V1. Drift speed of this electron, second electron is V2. Drift speed of this third electron is V3. Drift speed of this fourth electron is nothing but what? V4. Then we can assume. Means average drift velocity can be defined as sum of the drift speed of all the electrons which are present inside the conductor, that is said to be average drift velocity. Average is nothing but that is denoted by capital VD. V1, drift speed of first electron, drift speed of second electron, drift speed of third electron, up to how many number of electrons are there? N electron, up to nth electron, means V1 plus V2 plus V3 plus up to Vn by the what? N. This is nothing but what? Average drift velocity. Here you have to remember one thing. The average drift velocity cannot accept the zero value, which is not equals to zero value. Average drift velocity. Why? Because suppose when we connected to the battery, the flow of electrons are there like this. They can move randomly like this. Means this is having some kind of the speed. This is also having some kind of this. Suppose if V1 is not deviated, then you can assume that is what is zero value. Suppose V2, it is deviated. So this is nothing but some kind of the value. V3, it is having some kind of the value. So always average drift velocity cannot accept in the zero value. You have to remember two important short answer questions, that is nothing but drift speed is always responsible for electric current. Next one, average drift velocity cannot accept the what? Zero value. That is nothing but here how can we calculate the drift speed? Here drift speed is nothing but it is shortcut definition for drift speed is the speed of electron, that is said to be drift speed. Next one here, what is the formula for this drift speed? Number of electrons in a conductor. Then we would like to know the how many number of electrons are there inside the conductor. That is nothing but here n into value. Total number of electrons are there, n and its value. A is nothing but any cross-sectional area. This is area, you can assume this is any cross-sectional area. And Vd is nothing but what? Drift speed. Total charge Q is equivalent to the what? Current. So here I is equals to nq into AVD. Okay? Means total whatever it may be, number of electrons or drift speed or anything, that is equals to the what current? I is equals to nq into AVD. This VD is nothing but what? Drift speed. VD is equals to I by nqA. This is nothing but what? Drift speed. What is the importance of drift speed? Is drift speed of the electron which is responsible for electric current. Next, another topic is nothing but what? Electric shock. What is the electric shock? How the human body can affected by the electric shock?
Then in our own house, how much voltage of electric current is there? 240 volts of electric current is there. Then when we touch the electric wire, then what happened? 240 volts of electric current is there. When we touch that one, here in total human body, okay, total human body, here different types of organs are there. Heart is there, kidney is there, like that, different types of the organs are there. Like that, skin also one of the organ like that. Here, total human body, skin is having a more resistive power, more resistance power. Resistance power is nothing but which is having, which opposes the electric current. Okay, skin is more resistive power than the remaining organs. Then we touch the, suppose you can assume this is electric wire, then you touch this electric wire, what happened? Major, the flow of electrons are which will inject into what? Human body. Always the flow of electrons search for the path which is having the what? Low resistance. When we touch the electric wire like this, the flow of electrons are like this to the hand and like this. One path is downward, one path is upward, one path is left to right, like that there. Then the flow of electrons always search for the path, downward path or upward path or backward path, which path is having the low resistance. Then those can be the electrons are flows into the water, human body. Then I value, whenever the flow of electrons are injected into the human body, I value is if 0.01, that can be felt. Human body, that may be felt. If I value is 0.05, it's painful. Then we may suffer a lot. Next, if the I value is 0.070, that causes the what? Heart diseases and seriousness. Suppose then you can assume the skin is more resistive power than the remaining organs. Skin resistive power is how much? Then you can assume 10,000 ohms are there. 10,000 ohms. Then according to the ohms, I is equal to what? V by R. Then how much voltage of current is there inside of 240? Then what is the R value of skin? 10,000. Then what is the value of this one? 0.024. So this is nothing but what I value. Based on this principle, then we may calculate. Okay, then based on this principle, if the values are like this, 0.01 can be felt, 0.05 is painful, 0.07 heart diseases are same. In that moment, whenever the human body can affected by the electric shock, then multi organs may be damaged. Then the human body may go into water, die. This is about the today's chapter. In this chapter, you have to remember only thermal velocity. It is nothing but before connected to the battery, drift velocity. It is connected to power supply. And means what is nothing but connected to the battery flow of electrons are there. This is nothing but average drift velocity. Okay, drift velocity, drift speed is always responsible electric current. This is not accepting the what? Zero values.